Apple's latest MacBook Air and Pro laptops come with a 45-watt MagSafe 2 power adapter, plus an AC wall plug and power lead. These great Mac laptops will work fine straight out of the box, but many Mac users will need to add various adapters and cables to make full use of their Mac setup. For instance, none of the latest MacBook Airs or Retina MacBook Pros feature an optical DVD drive anymore. If you still use DVDs or CDs for backup or just importing your music collection, then you'll need to add an Apple USB SuperDrive with attached USB cable. These are compact and lightweight, so you can carry them on trips if you want to, but they aren't cheap, costing £65 or $79. Apple's latest MacBook Air and Retina MacBook Pro laptops do not feature an Ethernet port anymore. Apple expects everyone to use Wi-Fi for their internet connections, but this isn't the fastest way to connect your laptop to the internet or your home or office network. Apple's £25 or $29 Thunderbolt to Gigabit Ethernet adapter lets you connect to a high-performance Gigabit Ethernet network via the Thunderbolt port on your MacBook and provides an RJ45 port that supports 10, 100, 1000 base T networks. While the MacBook Pro boasts two for Thunderbolt ports, the MacBook Air has just one. If you're using this one Thunderbolt port to connect an external display or projector, you won't be able to simultaneously connect via Ethernet using this adapter. Instead, invest in the Apple USB Ethernet adapter. This connects to the USB port of your MacBook Air and provides an RJ45 connector that supports 10, 100 base T performance. Use Apple's mini DisplayPort to DVI adapter, which costs £25 or $29, to connect an advanced external display or projector that includes a DVI connector. You can use an external display as your main workspace or to extend your desktop, or you can work in mirrored mode with a projector so you can view what your audience sees. For older, less advanced displays or projectors, you need Apple's mini DisplayPort to VGA adapter, again £21 or $29, which can connect the MacBook to a standard analog monitor, projector or LCD that uses a VGA connector or cable. If you have an old FireWire drive or device that you need to connect to your new MacBook Pro or MacBook Air, then you can buy Apple's Thunderbolt to FireWire adapter, again £25 or $29. This connects your Thunderbolt-equipped Mac to a FireWire device using the laptop's Thunderbolt port to give you a FireWire 800 port that supplies up to 7 watts for bus-powered peripherals like hard drives and audio devices. Beware though, as some devices, such as the G-Tech G-Raid Mini, require more power than this adapter can provide. You might be better off saving up for a proper Thunderbolt hard drive, although these aren't cheap or plentiful right now. Not an Apple-branded product, the Belkin Mini DisplayPort to HDMI adapter lets you connect your MacBook or MacBook Air to your HD TV. It costs £25 or $35. It delivers both digital audio and video signals for easy data transfer. It converts video to connect to any device enabled with HDMI technology and supports full 1080p resolution video. Using it, you can connect your MacBook to any HD TV to browse the internet, share photos, and stream audio or video from a variety of sources.